We're taking this overgrown, unused rock garden and front yard, and we're gonna transform it into something that is absolutely amazing and one of a kind.
I cried. I still wanna cry. I still go, this is my yard.
Right.
This is my pond.
We only have 10 days before our client's 50th anniversary. To make this happen and make sure we have no delays in our schedule, I'm gonna need all hands on deck. This is the design we have for the space right now. She doesn't like this design anymore. We started talking and I think she actually wants a pond. This is the lady that runs the Bodacious Bazaar. She's been walking by here every day.
Awesome.
And I think she's just gotta have some fish. So I did an updated design. But Jim, Pat, I don't think this is where it ends. I think this is where it starts. I think you need to get out there and need to be creative with her and just see what she wants and make sure that we deliver what she's asking for. I have a feeling it's gonna grow something.
At the end of the day, she's the one living there. So that's right. Give her what she wants.
Intention of this space is she has a spot right here that she likes to sit. Kind of the idea was that we would wrap it around here. Really important to save this maple. Very special for her, that maple. They also have like a walkway that comes in through here. So you kind of see how I have the stream going along beside the walkway. Also an important element. As people come into the backyard, really want them to experience that water. I want her to have a tranquil spot where she can sit and just enjoy. And then because this is in the front yard, we have street traffic right here. So I want to make sure we're not blocking it, but I also want to put our work on display so everybody who's driving by can see the stuff that we can build.
Yeah. Sounds like fun.
You guys got it?
Yep.
Let's make it happen.
Let's do it.
We're on design iteration number 4 with this front yard. What started out as a simple stream grew into a 10 by 17 pond with that same simple stream, and now has an intake bay, a whole nother section of flowing water, a bridge over a walkway, and it's just morphed into this totally different and absolutely epic water feature. I understood their motivation for wanting a water feature before we even started, but as the different design iterations evolved, I got a deeper understanding of how important water was to them as a couple, and also something that they had been dreaming for almost 50 years. That's right, they've been married 50 years, and this pond is for their 50th wedding anniversary. The bad part about all this is, even with all these design iterations, I only had about 8 weeks heads up, which meant we had to get boulders, which means we had to get different pond equipment. This entire thing morphed from week 1 to week 8 into something that I think we're gonna struggle to pull off in time for her wedding anniversary. Let's go to Pat and see what he's dealing with on the job site.
All right, guys, we're in Poquoson today. And as you can see, this project is a little bit further along. Normally, part of this process, you guys would see me paint some lines down so I can show you how things are gonna lay out and how it's gonna tie into the existing space. But because Jim kind of grew our scope of work a little bit, I have no idea how this thing is gonna lay out just yet, so I'm not gonna waste our time. But I am gonna talk about how much everything weighs. Between all of our gravel, our pavers, our spikes, snap edge, polymeric sand, we're looking at a total of about 26,000 pounds. That's roughly 5 of those fellas right there. Between all of the liner, the underlayment, the boulders, the pea gravel, pumps, the fountainscapes, all of that, including water weight, is around 83,000 pounds just in this little compact space. That's like the size of one full industrial size bulldozer. Imagine that thing just plopped right in the center there. Between all of our hardscape materials and all of our pond materials, we're looking at 109,000 pounds, pretty close to like 3 Post Malone's tour buses.
Congratulations, that's amazing.
Whenever I get a chance to install this walkway, what we're gonna use is Bellegarde's Brooklyn 3x9 paper in midnight black. And we're gonna lay it kind of like in a herringbone pattern. Again, coming off of the driveway in some sort of fashion, I already have a massive problem. So originally this job started out as a 10 by 17 pond with a 14 foot stream. And as you can see, this is just a hair larger than a 10 by 14. Now, we're supposed to have this really nice flowing walkway that came off of the driveway and is gonna turn right into the front entrance over there. Now I gotta figure out what to do about it.
We have a problem.
Okay.
We have rocks on the way. We've been given a timeline anywhere from sometime tomorrow to sometime next week.
I have people coming from all over. They're
right.
Coming from Texas. I have one coming from Minnesota and one coming from, they're Florida. They're coming from everywhere to meet here because it's our 50th wedding anniversary that Saturday.
While Jim is doing everything he can without rocks, I'm gonna get on the road and go see if I can find something special for him to build into this pond.
Yeah, we just built like a, I'll show you a picture of it. So we built like ponds. We built the path and the whole pond and water feature.
All I know is the watermans used them, you know, to like crab and fishing and different things.
Yeah.
That's the pitch into them and the width of the water.
Okay, so is that like if you're trying to look for more torque? I kind of like this one a little bit better. I like the patina though, because I think I'm looking for it to be decorative.
Decorative.
Yeah.
I got old motors too.
Yeah. Oh yeah, little wheel.
Yeah, another old motor on there.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
That's really old though, isn't it?
Yeah. 200,
well, I like this one. I'll buy this one if you're all right with that.
Right.
How much did you want for it?
600.
Okay.
You want the shaft to go with it?
If you're up for letting the shaft go, I'm up for it.
You could put your pulley on the end and have you like a little motor on the end that would just lift it and just turn it over, you know?
Yeah.
Honestly, I came here looking for just one prop. But after hanging out with him for about 30 minutes, I was absolutely fascinated with everything he had on the property. And man, he has a lot for sale.
Old.
For sale too. These here, they use them on boats too. I got big ones, little ones.
Yeah, right.
They cost $200 for that thing brand new. It's like $10 a piece for them. You know, boss, and they set them over and let them grow into it.
Well, thank you again.
All right, bro.
I'll send you a picture of this once it's built in.
You don't need a net reel going that yard, do you?
A what?
Net reel. It goes for like $5,000 or $6,000. I got this on sale for $3,000. I seen Bigfoot, I believe.
You do? Really?
There had to be Bigfoot down in Virginia. I seen that thing before.
Really?
I believe I'll be back here. Actually, I'll definitely be back, and we'll see what else he's got for sale in our next project.
I appreciate it, man. This has been great.
We'll buy a aluminum boat going to yard.
All right, let's head back to the shop and unload the boulders that just arrived.
Morning, buddy. How's it going? So I heard we got our boulders in a little bit last minute. How are we looking timeline wise?
We had the celebration on Saturday. We got all that rain coming in, so it's go time. So it'll be tight.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to make a couple calls, see if I can get all hands on deck so we can knock this thing out for you.
Okay, yeah. Let's pray that the rain holds off.
Yes, sir. All right, well, I'll make some calls. We'll get after it.
That sounds good, buddy.
Finally, Jim's back on site. He has his boulders and he is ready to rock and roll. These boulders really did come in just in time. We are only 2 days before her anniversary guests are starting to show up at the house. I absolutely love how he was able to create some pillars with the boulders and then use some large steppers across his boulders to create this bridge. And the bridge has a couple holes in it and you can see the water as you walk over. Wednesday went by really quick. Jim placed a lot of boulders and they worked an extremely long day in over 90 degree heat and they were completely tuckered out. So Pat really did pull through. He got almost everybody here. We had Frank's maintenance team. We had the hardscape guys here. We even had our other landscape team on site and it was all hands on deck on Thursday. And it was raining and it was miserable, but these guys really pulled through.
I could see this going behind the waterfall. I could see this cutting the shaft and having it like in the stream turning.
Mm-hmm. Well, if we put it in the stream, we might have sushi because this fish is supposed to be swimming in the stream.
Yeah.
We have a lot of water coming down off those urns. If we have a good enough bearing, we would actually have that be able to stand upright in the center of those three urns and have it spin.
Gonna need to grease the pole.
Could do is.
Let me figure that out. Let me see if she first likes it and then we'll go from there.
It's a big surprise.
Big surprise.
It's a heavy surprise.
Big. You know, I don't go small.
So I have an idea with this. Just thinking because of your husband, you know, working in the shipyard constantly.
My daddy was in the Navy.
So it's just, I thought nautical is the theme that needs to go here.
Uh-huh.
So I went looking for anything that could have like the nautical theme and I ended up on like an actual brass, real live prop. Because this prop is not built for speed. This is a torque prop. Mm-hmm. And in marriage, right, speed doesn't get you anywhere. And so he had two. He had one that was built for speed that would get a boat going faster, and he had one that was more torque. So I picked the one that has a little bit more torque to it. Can I build this into your pond? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Awesome.
Yes.
So
yes.
This isn't it. I have one more thing. So I was looking at all of your fairy gardens and all your stuff, all of your knickknacks and stuff like that. And I said, I want something that is like fits with that vibe, but also has kind of like a antique-y kind of feel, but also has maybe like a water vibe. So I took to Facebook Marketplace.
Okay.
This guy wouldn't let us film him with us buying it, but it was such a perfect fit for your pond that I couldn't help but get.
Love it.
It's a music wheel.
Oh my god!
I just felt like this was like the perfect.
Oh yes.
And so now we have hers and his.
I love it. Sweet. It's got to go right there.
Yep.
I know exactly where it needs to go.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh. So good. How
are you doing there?
You need to come and see what I'm living in.
I feel like I'm on an island.
Oh, this is, yeah, what a place to be, what a place to be stuck on.
Right?
It's a long time coming, right? It's many years I've wanted a pond, but never in my wildest dreams did I have this.
Right.
I cried. I still want to cry. I still go, this is my yard.
Right.
This is my pond. The first time we pulled in and it had water running in it, I got out and couldn't even talk, which is unusual. Which is a very unusual thing. But
I know you were giving Jim a hug, and Jim was like drenched in sweat and all dirty. And you're giving him a hug. I'm like, ooh. Okay.
I couldn't let go of him. I just wanted to cry and cry and just cry in joy. It was like, oh, it's everything. What really touched us was how you really took each one of our personalities and brought us something. I mean, that was enough to bring us a pond.
What's your favorite thing about the pond? From everything that's here to just one feature, what's your favorite thing?
I love the bridge.
Okay.
Right here in the fish.
Him and the fish. They're all under there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's where they
Which
step.
We knew yeah. that this was going to be their cave. They're going to
hang
out
it.
Here.
They love it.
Yeah.
I have to say the thing that my eye goes to always and I sit next to is the waterfall and that the way the mister and the
rolls.
Fog rolls over it and the sound. Well, you finished on my anniversary.
Coincidence, right?
Right.
I had asked you to, and everyone was like, there's no way. There's no way they can do it that fast. That morning, even with all this huge party we were having that night, we took the time to run to the pet store.
Yep.
And we grabbed 50 goldfish, and we set the goldfish free.
Yep.
What started out as a $30,000 project ended up morphing into an over $80,000 project. They added all of the bells and whistles, to include 3 stacked slate urns, 1 scalloped urn, a 19-inch spillway bowl, a 40-inch terracotta patio bowl, 2 9,000-gallon-per-hour pumps, 2 biofalls, 2 misters, a boulder bridge, 18 feet of stream, an intake bay with 13 aqua blocks, and 2 pump faults, all wrapped in a 25x50 liner. I'm gonna call this a success. Get outside, my friends. Stream, an intake bay with 13 aqua blocks and 2 pump faults, all wrapped in a 25x50 liner. I'm gonna call this a success. Get outside, my friends.